about a blessedness that happens to a man whose delight is in the law of God. So as someone says, it says, but his delight is in the law of God, and doth he meditate day and night. He says that that man is like a tree planted by the rivers of water, whose leaves do not wither, and who bears fruit in every season. As you are about listening to this message, we believe that your life is going to be like that man planted by the rivers of water. Your leaves are forever going to bear. And we know that your season will not pass by. You will forever shine and you will forever bear fruit. We have a lot of content to share with you. So we would entreat you to subscribe to this channel, as well as like us. Hit that notification bell to receive more updates from us, because we know that whatever content here is going to set you on course at every time. It's going to make you attain whatever stature that Christ wants you to attain. Thank you.
You'll soon be seated. Just be patient with me. The Lord is doing a quick work in it. There are people who God wants to deliver from the spirit of fear. You have lived perpetually in fear. There are realms you would have stepped into, but everything God has told you, the fear of moving forward, the fear of what people will say, the fear of yesterday. You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance. Whenever I am afraid, I will trust. I want you to know that Jesus is here more than a man of God. This is not a show. This is the Lord Jesus revealing himself in the midst of his people and calling them to deeper levels. Is doing. You don't have to be out here. Something is happening to you. There is a breaking of the flesh. There is a release even of the spirit. You will leave this place and see that things have changed in your life. Angela. Who is Angela? I'm hearing a name, Angela. And the Lord is saying, I should tell you, remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. For the Lord is saying, I should tell you, behold, I do a new thing. And I pray, the past that is holding on to you and will not let you go, I break you free from it right now, by the power of the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord is showing me a woman, 7 years you've not had a child. Who is that? The Lord wants to change your life now. 7 years. 7 years. Is there a woman like that? There are cries of adoration. I see men from men. Every nation, lift your voice to make your glory known. for the fruit of the womb. I saw 7 years. Who is that? These two women? Why are these ones here? Huh? Angela, I want to pray for you. The power of God is coming on two of you. Just stand where you are. I just saw light coming on two of you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare for Angela, my God is shifting you to a new season. I'm seeing light coming. The power of God is coming. Let this be the beginning of a new season for you. In the name of Jesus and by the Spirit of the Christ, I declare that the limitations that you came for this meeting with, may they leave you like smoke before the wind. In the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands now. Even by the Spirit, I saw the power of God coming on two of you. May that anointing that makes for the next level of your destiny, may that grace be released upon you now. In the mighty and even the marvelous name of Jesus Christ, I declare this even by the Spirit of God. You will never be the same. By that anointing, one of you, that anointing that is coming on you is the grace for restoration. You have lost several things in your life, and the Lord is telling you that He is going to restore. The little one is also Angela. In the name of Jesus, I pray that the hand of God will rest upon you right now. In Jesus' name. 7 years you're trusting God. Who is Ifunaya? Ifunaya, I just heard the name Ifunaya. You'll be seated shortly. Ifunaya, is there someone like that? What are you turning to wine? You open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. What are you turning to say? As you can, out of her now, the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare, every spirit that is not of the Christ, it leaves never to return, in the name of Jesus Christ. My dear, look at me. You too, shout Jesus. Let it never return to you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Listen, when you see God walk like this, please listen, let me say this, hold on. You see, more than just showing that a man is powerful, if that is all you see, you have not seen well. You see clearly when you see Jesus lifted and glorified in and through the frailty of men. Are we together? This is what I want you to see beyond the manifestations of men, to see you high and lifted up. You are shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love. We sing holy, holy, holy. We'll see you high and lifted up. You are shining. I stretch my hands and I pray for you. Everything that has not been planted by my God at work in your life and at work in your destiny, I come here tonight visiting this land and I decree and declare in the name of Jesus, as was revealed to me by the Spirit of the living God. Let it come to an end now. There is someone, there's something growing among those in front here. There's something in your stomach that the devil has put is a growth. I see the healing power of Jesus touching it right now. There is a strong anointing coming on you right now. The Lord is bringing healing. I'm going to be praying for the sick shortly. But in the name of Jesus, that every tree that has not been, oh my God, Embrekidi shadaka tabraske di balaka tuziata kaprande katosha tiata lagretiskiata. There is no hiding place in the name of Jesus, for the light shineth in darkness. The Bible says, and the darkness comprehended it not. I declare, let it be out of your body now. Let it be out of your system now. Out of your body now and out of your system now. And for all of you in front here that I called, I decree and declare, rise to a new dimension in the spirit. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I know that there are many people here who may belong or desire this category I'm about to call. But there is a particular gentleman. There is a particular gentleman that God is calling into two dimensions. One is a strong prophetic teaching grace. And then the other is a very strong healing anointing. I know there are many people who do the impartation, but I'm submitted to the Spirit of the living God. There is a gentleman, he's going to shout under the anointing now in the congregation, not among those who are here. Please let me have that gentleman. I want to speak over his life in obedience to the things that I see.
Is Jesus, I've got something more than gold, and I will tell it to my world. Jesus is more than gold. If all I have is Jesus, I've got something more than gold, I'll tell it to my world.
One of the things that I was very impressed with when I stepped in here was Pastor Ike giving visibility to one of our lovely daughters here, the lady who ministered. Now, you see, one of the things you have to learn in leadership is that a good leader does not just maintain followers. You must be able to raise and train people and give them visibility. Some of them will downplay your relevance. Don't worry. Already designed in the law is a system of honor that will not bend. Hallelujah. Now, so that lady, what's her name? Huh? Peace. May God bless you. Come, you're going to sing a song for me here.
Hannah, see, hallelujah. And I see, hallelujah.
Come on, South South.
Let's go!
there who are victims of delay, that the only thing growing in your life is your age. Nothing else seems to be growing. I want to take authority over that spirit before I pray for the sick. Delay. Whole families tied under the yoke of this wicked spirit. There are men and women of God, very gracious, loving, love Jesus with all their hearts. But this delay, I want to rebuke that spirit now. Are you ready now? From the front to the back, delay. Alongside every spirit that does not name the name of Christ. At the tree, I want you to shout that name, Jesus. And hear me, believers, if God be God, with that shout, Tehillah, that comes the end of Jericho as a limitation over your life. Are you ready now? I decree and declare by the power of the prophetic and in the name of Jesus that anyone here who is a victim of delay, that includes every family, every business, every ministry, for as long as that delay is in your life, it must answer to the power of the blood. At the count of three, shout Jesus. Are you ready now? 1, 2, 3, shout Jesus. I command delay. Go now. I release you. Everyone, help this woman who is a victim of delay. Every family, every ministry, wasting your time tonight. You will marvel and wonder at the testimonies that begin to happen to you. Now hear me, please. I'm beginning to sense a very strong manifestation of the healing anointing. And I'm attempting your body. Death attempting is an administration. Sickness is within the office of death. Because the final journey of sickness is that it causes a deterioration to your body to an extent that your spirit can no longer stay in your body. Are we together? I want to pray for you now. For all those in the front here, I want to speak over their lives and then they can go back to their seats so that I pray for the sick. Jesus again will be glorified in Asaba. For all those who are in front, I decree and declare, the Lord brought you here by His Spirit and by the power that raised Christ from the dead. If there be any spirit that is not consistent with the Spirit of the Christ in and through your life, I declare, be delivered now. But then, for whatever call God brought you out here, I declare, you become a partaker of that grace. You will go back and your life will be a visible expression of this grace that you have carried. Let it be so in the name of Jesus. Please return to your seat. I want to pray for the sick now. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord mighty in battle. Amen. Who is this King? Jesus. Let it be so. Amen. The healing ministry, please listen, because more than just the celebration of the healing power of Jesus, I believe that in every region, and that includes your region, that there are men and women that the Spirit of grace seeks to bring into the reality of the healing ministry. I can tell you this, that our generation has not really seen the healing ministry in its full strength. Here and there, there are people who operate in the gifts, people get healed, but you need to be a good student of scripture and of modern history to see the spectacular manifestation of the healing ministry as an office. And I believe that before Jesus returns to the earth, there will be a very definite restoration of that mantle, that men and women, listen carefully, will begin to carry this mantle of healing. Mantle of healing. There are nations that need to be healed, not just bodies. There are people that need to be healed. There are families that need to be healed. But for now, I want to pray for the sick. I believe in a miracle ministry. I am a miracle myself. I know what it means to be sick and oppressed, and I know what it means to see power that is in the name of Jesus come to heal, come to deliver. And so right now, wherever you are, scattered within this auditorium and following online across the nations of the earth, many of you have been afflicted and plagued by all kinds of things. Many of you are holding death sentences in your hands and in your body. I'd like to agree with you right now. Wherefore God has so highly exalted him, the Bible declares, and given him an office in a name. And that at the mention or at the name of Jesus, that every knee will bow of things in heaven, of things in the earth, and of things under the earth. And that every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord to the glory of the Father. So you believe in the healing ministry of Jesus. Matthew chapter 10 and verse 1. Jesus commissioned them and gave them power against unclean spirits to cast out demons. 7 and 8, he said that they should go and preach that the kingdom has come. And in preaching, they should validate the authority of the kingdom by healing the sick, by casting out devils, by raising the dead, that they have received freely, and they should be lavish in dispensing that benevolence. We've been mandated by God to heal. Healing is when the supernatural power of the Holy Spirit superimposes the limitations in a human body to cause regeneration, to cause creation, to cause recovery, to cause cure to whatever ailments, be it biological, largely demonic, according to Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. It says, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. The Bible declares that he went about doing good and healing all they that were oppressed. Healing, oppressed. Not those that were sick, those that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. Are we together? Lay your hands wherever you are trusting God for a miracle right now. Emmanuel. 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 Your name is called Emmanuel. Your name is called. Just keep your hands there. Emmanuel. Your name. I want you to agree with me as I pray right now. Believe by the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, there are two things I want you to do very quickly. As I pray for you, we still have a lot to do. The power of God is going to touch you where you are ailing, because Jesus has been exalted and glorified here. I sense a very strong move of the healing power of Jesus. Now, the moment a miracle happens to you, listen very carefully. I'm going to be declaring by the Spirit, and the moment a miracle happens, do what you couldn't do, test yourself. You find out that a miracle has happened. I want you to use either this in front here, or just this, okay, this or that. Either of the aisles, I want you to come and stand. We'll take a few testimonies. Then immediately afterwards, listen carefully. I'm going to minister deliverance one more time. And then, did you come with your prayer requests? Now, for those of you who, for whatever reason, you didn't write your prayer request, when I am done praying for the sick, I am going to give you an opportunity. And you will quickly write down your prayer request. Everything that has mocked God in your life, that you want to wave goodbye once and for all. We're going to collate all of that prayer, and I will bring it before the altar of the Lord. I have seen God answer prayers in ways that have changed my life, but my life and answer to prayers changed when I had the honor and the privilege of being alone in the prayer room of our Father in the Lord, Baba Adeboye. I was alone in that prayer room, and my prayer was not more power. My prayer is, oh God, the covenant and the grace that you have with this veteran of the gospel that has provided answer to prayer, whatever mantle it is, let it come upon my life, that from that time when I bow my knees to pray over people, let there be answers. And ladies and gentlemen, it worked like fire. I have seen God answer prayers, but not to this degree. We are products of the graces that we carry. We did not invent these mantles. We also received them from those that have gone ahead of us. And before this conference is over, I'm going to do an impartation. Somebody in this place must walk out of this place with a superior impartation upon your life that will set you ablaze even for a new season. In the name of Jesus. Are you ready for that? Did you bring the oil? Because oil must touch everybody's head in this place this night. Everybody. No matter what it is. Let me have the oils, please. Did they bring their own, or is there an... Someone advise me. Do you have bottles of oil here? Let's have the bottles and the vessels. What will happen is that once it's time, now unto the one upon the throne, we raise a sound, we raise a sound. For you are God and God alone, hallelujah. Bring the oil out. Someone come and help me. This lady, come. You're doing some work, so you come, and you're a woman of God now. So you bring the oil out. Huh? Praise the Lord. By the way, I'm going to pray for her. Yes, bring all of them, all the bottles out, so that we'll pray and still open gates by the Spirit for her life and her ministry. As God grants us grace, this is what we continue to do. Helping men and women who have stayed through with discipline to find visibility and continue to multiply as they extend the hand of God. I know she's not the only one. There are many other people. Let me give you an advice. It's a spiritual advice and it's caution. Do not ever allow lifting make you so proud You see this, you see some of these things people do around and crash as soon as they rise. No matter how high you rise, remember that the stability of a tree is based on its connection to the root. Even the tallest building in the world still makes contact with the ground to stand. Are we together now? Yes. If God found you sweeping, even when God lifts you to the nations, bless the nations and run back and carry your broom and continue sweeping. We learned that from Mordecai. After he rode upon the king's horse, when he was done, he went back and remained there. If you are Mordecai and you ride on the king's horse, will you not go back? No, no, no. The people who said, bow the knee, now are watching you again. Because if he found you on your knees, remain there. That is where he lifts you. So let me advise you, fame and all this lifting, they can be very tempting, especially when the world begins to celebrate you. Apostle Joshua Selman. See, this is the thing that destroys many great people. The safest position for a believer is on your knees. Remain where he found you. Bless the nations. Enjoy the honor that comes with your grace, especially where you serve. Don't get too big that you feel I'm more anointed than my pastor. I'm more famous than him. No. So I'm using her life as an example. You see that now. She's singing. Maybe somebody's going to invite her tomorrow to go and do something and get and bless the nations. But now, don't be ashamed, darling, as you are walking and doing this. This is where the anointing finds you. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Yes. People respect you more when they see that you are conscious of authority. It shows you were well mentored. They will now be able to open you to certain delicate platforms without fear, because they understand that there is stability in your understanding. People who are easily lawless are people who certain platforms will not open for, because nobody wants you to come and destroy age-long sacrifices. Are we together? Let me pray for her so that she will go back to her seat. God bless you, darling. Stretch your hands towards her. May the Lord bless you and honor you. You will go from glory to glory. You will sing his praises across the nations. In the name of Jesus, I bless you. May Asaba open for you. New season, new dimension of grace and power. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus, God bless you. Let's celebrate her. God bless you, my dear. Thank you for doing the work here. Now, let's pray for the sick. Two people will shout under the anointing. Immediately that happens, the second person will shout now. Afterwards, the healing power of Jesus will begin to flow. Let's pray now. In the name of Jesus Christ, please shout aloud, Amen, Asaba. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I decree and declare that every spirit that is at the back of any infirmity in your body, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, we command that spirit to leave now. We command that spirit to leave now. Therefore, I decree and declare, be healed in Jesus' name. I bring life to your body in the name of Jesus Christ. Every blood disease here represented, be healed in the name of Jesus. Eye conditions, be healed in the name of Jesus. The Lord is healing someone in your right ear. In the name of Jesus, I command, whether total deafness or partial deafness, let that ear be unstopped and open now. Bone conditions, whether you're here on crutches, a wheelchair, or having all and any kind of bone condition, by the power that raised Christ from the dead, I declare strength to your limbs now. Be healed in the name of Jesus. There's someone, you've had this for a very long time, very pounding headache, looks like migraine. It will come and go, and when it comes, you almost cannot do anything. You can even almost fall on the floor. In the name of Jesus, the power of the Holy Ghost is touching you now. Touching you now. Every growth in your body, lumps in the breast, fibroids, and all kinds of growths in any part of your body, help those under the anointing. In the name that is above all names, I declare right now, healed in Jesus' name. My God, I sense such a strong anointing. Be healed in Jesus' name. There is someone, you have problems with your kidney. In the name that is above all names, you've been having the pain you think is appendicitis at the right side of your lower abdominal region. And I'm seeing that this is something that is like a kidney problem, but at its infancy. This is what the Lord is showing me. In any case, I decree and declare brand new kidneys for you now. There's someone you don't see well. You're not blind, but you don't see well at all. In fact, from where you are, you're unable to see the stage and the LEDs very clearly. Place your hand on your eyes. In the name that is above all names, I decree and declare clarity of vision right now. And for every blind eye, partial or complete, eyes be opened now in Jesus' name. Someone you have, there's something around your groin area here, like a lymph node, but it has remained there for a very long time and it has refused to go. Right now, in the name of Jesus, it disappears from your body. Heart problem, I declare healing right now. In the name of Jesus, there's someone here, your elder sister has a son who is autistic. The power of God is touching that boy right now. We rebuke that sign and that trace of autism in the marvelous name of Christ. Pile, painful pile, I rebuke it right now in the name of Jesus. The issue of blood, it comes under judgment now in the name of Jesus Christ. Even though I'm praying for the sick, the Lord is just ministering someone's case for me. There is an acute manifestation of disfavor in your life to the point that even your own family people are not willing to help you. I don't know who that person is, but the power of God is coming on you right now as I'm speaking, and the Lord is saying it was an attack, a programming of darkness over your life. It's not as though you are an evil person. This is a demonic embargo upon you. I don't know where that person is, but I just saw fire just into this auditorium. Wherever you are, in the name of Jesus and by the prophetic, I remove that embargo from your life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Help them, that's right. In the name of Jesus Christ.
My deliverer is standing by. Your deliverer is coming. Your deliverer is standing by.
Someone you have, your rib area, severe pain. In fact, you cannot lie down facing the bed. You have to just lie down at the side or lie down facing up because there's severe pain around your rib. Right now, the power of the Holy Spirit is touching you. In the name of Jesus, I'm seeing someone, you can't do this with your fingers. I don't know what the problem is, but there's been severe pain and discomfort. Right now, the power of God is touching you and He's bringing life, He's bringing healing. In the name of Jesus. Now, don't be embarrassed. I'm praying and I'm seeing in my vision, there is someone, it's not lack of hygiene, but I don't know, it looks like severe mouth odor. This has embarrassed you. Those very close to you have even encouraged you to do something. You've done all you know to do. I think it's like you've even seen a dentist to just look at everything and find out what is going there. There's a pungent smell that just comes out of your mouth. You've done your best, you've brushed, you've done everything, and it looks like it's not going. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I'm praying for you. The power of the Holy Spirit is touching you right now. Right now. In the name of Jesus. Right now. In the name of Jesus. I'm seeing someone you have, I think a sister or a relative in the United Kingdom. That person is very sick right now. In UK, very, very sick. And If we do not pray, I see that that person may not make it. But in the name of Jesus, who is the Son of the living God, the author of life himself, we knock on the door of life for their sake. By reason of this conference, may the Lord preserve them, even those who are appointed unto death, in the name of Jesus. Now, whether I mention your case or not, in the name of Jesus Christ, back pain, like severe back pain around the lumbar area here, the power of God is touching someone in Jesus' name. The Lord is also showing me someone, your hands begin to shake. This is not shaking under the anointing. Your hands just begin to shake like someone who has Parkinson's. You're a young person, but your hand begins to shake and it looks like shock in your body. You know how sometimes you lie down on one side of your body and when you wake up, you have to stretch for blood to flow. There's someone like that. You don't have to lie down, but you feel that shock, that pain. The power of God is touching you right now. There is a gentleman here, your uncle is suffering from prostate cancer. In the name that is above all names, wherever he is, let the power of God right from this auditorium, through the airwaves, may it touch your uncle wherever he is. In the name of Jesus. Now, whether I mention your case or not, in the name of Jesus, who is the Son of the living God, I decree and declare, be healed right now. Some of you, whilst you fell under the anointing and you came out, God was doing something marvelous in your life. Now, in the name of Jesus, I want you to check yourself. Let us bring glory to the name of the Lord very quickly before we get into the prayer and the anointing. You are here and you see that the power of God has touched you before, during, and after this prayer. Very quickly and very boldly, I want you to leave your seat as we clap for them. Make your way to any of the people in front here. People are coming. Are you celebrating what Jesus is doing? Don't be afraid. Celebrate them as they come. Check yourself. The moment you find out that a miracle has happened, please come quickly. Lord, you reign and you rule over all. Let's celebrate them as they come. My God, unto you we ascribe all the praise. Happening. Everyone, please bring out your prayer request right now. Right about now, please bring out your prayer request. And here's what I want you to do for me. Whilst we're taking a few testimonies, please, pastors, just attend. Let's take a few notable ones and then we'll do a general prayer for sake of time. Now, here's what I want you to do. Please, everyone, lift your prayer request. There should be an officer or someone by your side. Now, please hand over the prayer request to the last person by the aisle. Let's do it from maybe my right to my left or whichever direction. Nobody's reading your prayer request. Just hand it over to whoever is at the side so that the ushers, please walk around very quickly. Walk around very quickly and collect the prayer requests. Everyone, please, quickly. You don't need an envelope. Just write it on a piece of paper and you submit it. And if you are yet to write one, you have a minute or two to write very quickly. Or perhaps you wrote a few requests, but there were still some more that you wanted to write. Now is your chance. Release your faith. Because in the name of Jesus, everything written there will come for you as a testimony. Are we together? Are we ready to take a few testimonies? Go ahead, very quickly.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, quickly.
Apostle, sir, this is Ogbonnaya. It was the case you mentioned about short-sightedness.
Short-sightedness.
Yes, it was the screen were very blurry, but as of now, he can see very well.
How long has this been, my friend?
Over 4 years.
Yes, sir. And right now you can see clearly.
Very clearly.
Come on, Asaba, you giving Jesus praise. In the name of Jesus, I stretch my hands and I declare your healing remains permanent. In the name of Jesus. Yes, please, very quickly.
Apostle, this is very notable. When you were ministry, you mentioned somebody who had a problem with the ear.
Yes.
So this lady came up and said, for some time now, her ear has been blocked. She intended to go to the hospital tomorrow to go and flush the ear. But while you mentioned her case, she felt a heat sensation on her ear, and now she can.
And right now, it's open. How long has this been, my dear? Do you know?
I had it last year.
Okay.
I went to hospital. It went. Then came back this
and then
year.
It came back now.
Yes.
And right now it's open.
Yes, sir.
May everything that has been closed, that should not be closed over your destiny, the same God that opened the ears of this our dear sister, may he open everything that needs to be opened. In the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you, my dear. It never returns to you again in Jesus' name. Very quickly. Yes, please.
So this is Jeremiah. He was the one you mentioned about Parkinson's disease while you were praying.
Parkinson's?
Yes, sir.
And you're a young man. What happened to you?
I had an attack about 2011.
Okay.
Yes, I was just in the room 31st night, and it was like half my body like a.
Okay, like stroke.
Yes.
And then from that time,
yes,
your hand,
yes,
and right now,
it's gone
completely. Yes. In the name of Jesus, it will never return to you again. Let's take some from here. Yes. Someone help her with the mic, please. Is it working? Or you want to use my own mic? Technical people? Yes. Help us with the mic. Yes, go ahead.
Praise the Lord. She said for 17 years she has had a problem with retaining urine, but in the course of the
17 years retaining urine.
Yes.
What does that mean?
She cannot hold urine for any length of time.
Oh,
she has
dear.
To rush during the course of
now,
the program.
You look at this kind of embarrassment to a precious daughter of Abraham like this. Did you know what it means to not be able to retain urine? It means you can be embarrassed as a woman. Now put yourself in the shoe of this lady as a woman. But the Bible says how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. And right now, what happened to her?
She's fine. Said in the course of the program, she has not had cause to urinate at all.
Wow. In the name of Jesus, my dear, by the power of the Holy Spirit, this embarrassment, this reproach leaves you now and leaves you forever in Jesus' name. Let's bless the Lord for her. Yes, please, very quickly.
She said she had problem with focus, and in the course of the prayers, she felt that something left her ear and an arrow left her back.
Also. With focus?
Yes.
Distraction is a wicked spirit. The Bible says if your eye be single, then your body will be full of light. The moment you are double-minded, the Bible says of such a man, let that man not think that he will receive anything from the Lord. In the name of Jesus, stability to your life, stability to your mind, stability to your focus. In Jesus' name I pray. Yes, please, go ahead.
This lady says she had back pain, severe back pain before now, but because of the prayers, the back pain has disappeared.
For how long, my dear? Fine. How long has this been?
For a month now, sir.
Complete. No pain again. Check yourself. Any pain? Any pain? Turn around. Left, right. Any pain? Are you celebrating Jesus, Asaba? In Jesus' name, back pain never returns to you again. Amen. Yes, please. Go ahead. Are you ready? Hold the mic. Please help us technical. Do we have, or do you need to take my own mic?
Praise the Lord.
Okay, yes.
He said he has been having ulcer and partial blindness, but in the course of the prayer, the partial blindness has.
Partial blindness. Oh dear, look at him. What's your name?
Israel.
Israel. The one with the promise and the covenant. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Partial blindness and what else?
Ulcer.
Ulcer. You're too young for ulcer. I rebuke this in the name of Jesus. I declare that they both leave you and grant you access to liberty and peace. In the name of Jesus Christ. Do we have someone helping them with a mic here? Oh dear. Technical, can you help us with one more mic, please, so that we can make this fast? Okay, let's just take a few.
Yes, sir. Apostle, this young man said he was severely sick from yesterday that prevented him from coming for the program, but in the course of the program, God healed him.
Okay, completely. How long? What was wrong with you?
I don't know. It was after some school activities.
Okay, you just began to feel
yes,
sick.
Sir.
In the name of Jesus, perfection comes for you and remains with you in Jesus' name. Let's celebrate Jesus. Yes, please, quickly.
Okay, Emeka, sir. He said he was having severe back pain, but during the course of the program, God healed him.
In the name of Jesus, perfection for back pain. In the mighty... Go ahead.
She could flex
go ahead and
now.
Let's see.
She
my God.
Flex the fingers now.
Completely.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ, this miracle is true for you. It remains with you. In Jesus' name I pray. Yes, please.
This lady said she came in here with a severe pain by the side of her ribs. And I remember you mentioned the case of somebody who had severe pain on the side of her ribs.
Is that pregnancy?
Yes, sir.
Are you pregnant? Give her the mic.
I'm not pregnant, sir.
Oh, my God. What is that? Have you gone to the hospital?
Yes, sir. They couldn't detect anything.
Are you seeing this? Please don't be embarrassed. Come. Look at this. This is a woman that it almost looks like she's 9 months pregnant. I think one time in Abuja, we prayed over a woman who had been pregnant for 2 years. Some of you were there. 2 years. You are not pregnant.
For 16 years, sir.
For 16 years.
Three years.
Madam, look at me. Don't be embarrassed. Don't be embarrassed. What is this? Have you gone to the hospital? Don't cry. What did the doctor say?
He said it's arthritis.
Arthritis? Massive water.
But they couldn't flush it out.
They couldn't flush it out.
I've been in FMC for more than 1 year. Going there every day.
You've done what?
They couldn't trust anything. She has been in the hospital for more than 1 year.
Oh my God. If this was the only reason why we held a miracle service tonight. I can't begin to put myself. Oh dear. This woman looks 9 months pregnant. Am I right on that? I thought she was pregnant. I wanted to bless the baby and say safe delivery. And now the devil, this is supposed to be like, so she goes for draining and it comes back, goes for, you know what it means to live your life like that? You see, sometimes when people see that we do these kinds of things, most times people think we're just wasting time. But you need to put yourself in the shoes of people who are at the back end of these miracles. Look at this dear woman now. Reminds me of the woman with the issue of blood. The Bible says she had spent all her earnings. She was not a lazy woman. She was just confronted with a situation. And many of you, God is showing you this. And he's using this situation to plant a burden in you. That you must continue to grow in this grace. Because you cannot wait for a conference like this. For people like this to be touched. What if this woman had died before this conference? Madam, do you believe in miracles?
Yes.
Place your hand on your stomach. I want to pray for you. Father, in the presence of your people here in Asaba, the spirit that is back of this, look what is happening to her. Are you looking at her hands? If you've never seen a miracle, watch one. In the name of Jesus, look at this. I command now. The spirit that is back of this. Out now. Out. The name of Jesus. Let her go. Release her destiny. In the name of Jesus. Let this woman have the opportunity to live a normal life. And to serve the purposes of the kingdom. And we not only pray healing, we pray restoration for every ₦1 and every $1 that she spent in the hospital. So shall it be that you will stand someday upon this hallowed altar and you will give God thanks because there will be no retention of water whatsoever. In Jesus' name I pray. Let's give Jesus praise for her. Yes, please, very quickly.
Apostle,
when we have, let me know when we're done. Please still waive your prayer requests. We're doing that very quickly. How many of you are yet to submit? Ushers, are you doing that? Please, let's have it in front very quickly, please. Protocol, Victor, help them. Let's work this. If there are still people, please very quickly waive it if you are yet to submit yours so that the ushers will have it. Ushers, when you have it, Let's collate it and have it in front here very, very, very quickly. We have to be fast. Yes, please.
Apostle said, this is good news.
Good news.
He's had toothache for over 10 years.
10 years? What happened to you?
I don't know where it came from.
Okay.
It just started like
just this. Discomfort now. And now?
It just disappeared.
Completely. Yes. It's gone. In the name of Jesus Christ, healing and perfection for you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Okay, do you have a mic there? Okay, go ahead.
Praise the Lord. This young man has had migraine headache for over 4 years, and in the course of the prayer, the migraine disappeared.
Migraine gone. It goes forever in the name of Jesus. Yes, please.
The lady behind is the one with the word when you said that there's somebody that cannot hold her hands. She can do that perfectly now.
Right now, go ahead.
She has a problem with her eyes.
Jesus.
And that is also healed in the name of Jesus.
Her eyes. Yes. Marvelous. In the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you, my dear. Never return to you again. Yes, please.
This woman says she has always had problem with her voice box, that she cannot sing, she cannot raise
her voice box.
Yes.
How long, my dear?
Since 2019, December, after I did my first album launching.
Your voice went?
Yes, sir.
Oh, dear.
I couldn't sing more than 5 minutes. It will just go off.
Sing something. Let the devil hear you sing.
Hallelujah. You are the power that raised Jesus from the dead. You are the power that gave sight to the blind to see. You are the power that gave legs to the crippled to walk. You are, you are, you are, you are so great.
Give Jesus praise. My dear, not only has God restored your voice box, we anoint you. Go back and continue from where you stopped. May the nations hear the sounds of your worship in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, please, very quickly. Go ahead. Go ahead. Okay.
Yes, Apostle. This man here said he's not been able to, he doesn't swallow, he spits. Anytime he does that,
You can't swallow.
Yes, it feels a lot of pain around this place, and I was asking if it was something like other pains around
yes,
here. He said no name was given after he visited hospitals and all that. But
once you swallow, you have severe pain.
Yes, yes.
And right now.
And the object moving up and down.
And right now.
Yes, sir. But after the prayer, I believe that the hand of God is upon me. I see the hand of God touching me.
In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare perfection for you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes, please, very quickly.
This young man here says he has been suffering from severe ulcer. He was trying to call Colonia Line to meet up with you, but he said he went for endoscopy one of the time, and he had a dream, and in the dream you asked him to come. So he began to look for your schedules to know which of the program you've been.
Oh,
he said
dear.
He just came in from Oka for this program. Why he came with the
You're just coming in from Oka? Oh my God.
He came with the pain so heavy, but as you began ministering, he couldn't find
and
the
right
pain.
And right now, check yourself. You see what the faith of the Son of God does. He comes all the way from Oka with faith in his heart, and now he's gone. Listen, may the Lord bless you. Not only would you receive this miracle, I pray that the favor of God will speak over your life. In the name of Jesus. For sake of time, let's see how we can just take 3 or 4. And then very quickly, I'll bless all of the people so we can go to pray for this, because the anointing, we want to do that fast, and I want everybody to be part of and partake of this. Hallelujah. Let's see how we can put a structure so that I'm not sure these bowls will be enough. I don't know how we'll do it. If the bowls are not enough, we'll just use a bottle of oil. So let's on this so that we'll make it really very.
Yes. That has defiled all kind of science.
He's a medical practitioner.
Yes, the doctor.
Oh. So he knows what he's saying. Doctor,
into it,
complete healing right now. In the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you.
He had that condition.
And right now?
He's gone. Before now, he said he saw you in the revelation where you prayed for him. So he had to travel all the way from Benin to attend this program. And as you mentioned the case, everything disappeared.
I've got the message from the Lord. Hallelujah. A message unto you I bring. 'Tis recorded in his word. Hallelujah. It's only that you look and leave. Look and leave, my brother, leave. Look to Jesus Christ and leave. I've got a message from the Lord. Hallelujah. It's only that you look and leave. In Jesus' name I declare the Lord preserves you, my friend. You will go back into a realm of favor. In Jesus' name I pray. Yes, please.
This young lady said she came in here tonight with a very severe pain. She couldn't do anything. She couldn't sit well. She couldn't stand well. But after the prayer, she noticed that the severe pain had disappeared.
Completely gone.
She could bend down now. She even bent down.
Praise the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus, I declare perfection for you, my dear, by the power that raised Christ from the dead. In Jesus' name. Yes, please.
She said she woke up yesterday morning and she began to feel a very severe pain underneath her breast region. Said the pain was so much and so heavy. When she came in tonight, she couldn't do so much because of the pain. But while you began to mean is that she felt a heat sensation and everything
That's right.
disappeared.
And it's gone now completely in the name of Jesus. Now, for sake of time, I want you to stretch your hands to all these people who have been healed from the left and the right. Speak over their lives. We're declaring perfection as the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. Is someone praying? Some of you, whilst you are praying, you are sowing a seed for this kind of experience in your own ministry. Go ahead and declare. In the name of Jesus, we choose to say thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We declare perfection in the name of Jesus Christ. Perfection in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord bless you. Let's give them a great God bless you. You can always feel free to testify in your local assemblies. Please do feel free to share your testimonies. The Lord bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. How many of you are ready to receive testimonies? Please rise up on your feet if you can. I want you to stretch your hands here. Praying upon the altar, there's no religiosity or ritual around it. This is an expression of your faith. The Bible says, unto thee that answers prayer shall all flesh come. I love to pray over requests like this because your prayer request is the most accurate expression of your desire. And the Bible says in Mark 11 and verse 24, it says, verily, verily, I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that thou receivest it and thou shalt have it. So it's an act of faith. You have written this. Please, let's have some more if you are still yet to submit yours. And those who are following from across the globe, whether or not you are able to submit your prayer request online, stretch your hands as an expression of your faith as we pray. Hallelujah. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Oh, our Father, hear us from heaven, forgive us sins, we pray. One more time. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be. Is the confidence that we have in him that when we ask anything that is in accordance to his will, he heareth us. Stretch your hands in one moment and I want you to begin to prophesy that these Egyptians I see today, I will see them no more forever. Go ahead. I'm going to be kneeling down. You can stand and pray. I bow my knees and I will pray. There is the covenant of answered prayer. Go ahead and pray. Pray in 1 minute. Are you declaring even by the Spirit of the Living God? Shabrendege de balakatuska de brandiga lakasuzia pahashia. Unto thee that answers prayer shall all flesh come. In the name that is above all names, we decree, we prophesy, we declare. Someone is praying. You're asking the Lord to bring miracles, answers. Shabrandeke bakatoska di brandeke di katala basidia. Lakraski di bashada gata brandaga de belekatus. When the Lord turn again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. And they said among the heathen, the Lord has done great things for us. He says, the Lord has done great things for us, whereof we are glad. And then he says, turn again the captivity of Zion like the streams of the Negev. Someone is praying. Shikapakatos kati brendegete balakatos yata. Embreteke paradosko to brendegete balakata. Shapreske, shapreske. Sheneskanda labakata brendegete balakatos yate. Arise, O God, in your majesty. Arise, O God, in your power. Go ahead and pray. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending broken hearts. I worship you. Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, that every request written here that has mocked the name of the Lord over your life, your family, and your destiny, in the name of Jesus, may that request be turned into your testimony now. May that request be turned to your testimony now. Hear me. Every human agent that must be in partnership with the Holy Spirit to make for answers to this prayer, we compel them to partner with the Holy Spirit now. And any man who says over his dead body for these prayers to be answered, may God answer their prayers. In the name of Jesus, Asaba, I prophesy to you that these Egyptians you see today, in the name of Jesus Christ, Egyptians of delay, Egyptians of joblessness, Egyptians of pain and shame and disgrace and embarrassment, you will see them no more forever. In the name of Jesus, some of you have written impossible things here that only God can answer. In the name that is above all names, may the Lord not only answer you, may he answer you speedily. And every spirit that is behind the pain written here, every spirit that is behind the shame written here, in the name that is above all names, I decree and declare that that spirit loses its hold over your life, loses its hold over your ministry, loses its hold over your family, loses its hold over your Christian experience, over your business, in the name of Jesus. And prophetically, I stand upon this prayer request and I decree and declare, the same way I'm standing upon it, everything that has risen above your head, I bring it down to your feet now, in the name of Jesus Christ. Taken all my pain, you've taken all my shame, you have taken all limitations.
patient. You've taken all disappointments. You have made them yours. The highest praise to the King. I give you worship, worship. The highest praise to the King. I give you worship, worship. Now listen, please, everyone, just listen to this instruction. We have two more things and we're done. Thank you for your patience. This is a very prophetic moment that we're stepping into now. Please do not be distracted. Be very discerning. Elijah told Elisha, if you can see me, he was already looking at him. Some of you, you have seen this thing in your dreams and your visions. You've seen expressions of this thing. Now God is giving you a chance to partake of grace that will change your life and will shift you into another man. Now here's what we're going to do. For the sake of time, listen carefully. You don't have to pour. I know some of you came with bottles of oil. Don't worry, I'll pray and speak over it for you. But for now, I don't know. I hope this oil will work. All I want you to do. Okay, now I'm told that there is a limitation here, and for the sake of time, that here's what will happen. I will pray and speak over your life, but then there will be people, since all of us have only about 3 or 4 doors, what will happen is when I am done praying, okay, and we wrap up everything, there will be someone standing at the doors with the oil. Is that fine? So that whilst you are going out, you just touch just on your head and your hand. Your head is symbol of your glory. Your hand is symbol of your productivity. And then you walk out. Will that be fine? It will help us conserve time. But in the name of Jesus, I bless these oils and I decree and declare that they no longer be ordinary oils. If you have a bottle of oil or you came with a point of contact, lift it up now. I want to speak over it prophetically. In the name that is above all names, I lay my hands upon this oil as a prophetic point of contact to whatever it is that you are lifting, whether your documents, whether some point of contact. In the name of Jesus, it becomes an instrument of fire from today. Believe it. In the name that is above all names, I decree and I prophesy over your life. That bottle of oil you are holding, in the name of Jesus, empowered by the word of God and by the Spirit of God, let it be used as an instrument to work wonders in your life. From tonight, it becomes a mantle in your hand, wherewith you will wrought signs and wonders. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Now, I want to make declarations over your life and I want you to receive it. Every door that has been closed over your destiny, right now I decree and declare, Asaba, you have received me as touching the grace that God has given. Therefore, in Jesus' name, every closed door be opened now in the name of Jesus. Hear me. Whatever has left your life that should not have gone, relationships, help them please. My goodness, you don't have to bring them out, just help them. Everything that has left your life that should not have left, the Bible says they are taken for a prey and none say yet restore. I decree and I prophesy by the hand of God, between now and December 31st, I speak to you in Jesus' name, let there be strange and speedy restoration. Strange and speedy restoration. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are some of you here, the Lord spoke to you from January and said he's sending people into your life to hold your hands and lift you. But this is November, you have not seen anyone show up. Let me prophesy to you. In the name of Jesus, I speak to the north of Asaba. I speak to the south, the east, and the west. I blow a shofar like Gideon, and everybody who must show up to hold. help you wherever they are. I command them to appear in your destiny now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hear me. For many of you who have been receiving this proverb, Ichabod, that the glory has departed from your life. For those of you who it looks like your yesterday is better than your today. You only have memories of what God did yesterday. You don't seem to have memories of what God is doing now. Right now, by the power of the Holy Spirit, may you begin to sing a new song after this conference. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I'm still praying for you. Jeremiah 51. Please give it to us from verse 50. We're discussing dominion. It says, thou art my battle axe. Do we still have Midian? And my weapons of war. Thou art my battle axe. And that you are also my weapons of war. Please, when you go back home, read it. Isaiah. Okay, we have it here. Jeremiah 51. Did I get that right? Verse 20, not 50. 51, verse 20. We're reading the first three verses. Thou art my battle axe and my weapon of war. Say amen. It says, with thee I will break in pieces the nations. With thee I will destroy kingdoms. With thee I will break in pieces the horse and his rider. I will break in pieces the chariot and his rider. With thee I will break in pieces man and woman, young and old. With thee I will break in pieces your young man and the maid. I will break in pieces the shepherd and his flock. I will break in pieces the husbandman and his yoke of oxen. I will break in pieces captains and rulers. That means everything God wants to do, you are that battle axe. Therefore, from tonight, the grace and the unction required for you to begin to walk in this level of dominion, may it land upon your destiny now. In the name of Jesus Christ. Luke 10:19. Luke 10:19. Very quickly. Behold, Asaba, I give you authority to tread upon serpents and scorpions. And over how many? How many? All the powers of the enemy. And it leaves you with an assurance that nothing shall by any means hurt you. Whether the means of the air, whether the means of the sea, whether the means of the earth, whether the means of land. Therefore, I declare, from tonight, manifest dominion over principalities and powers. Dominion over curses. Dominion over yokes. Dominion over enchantment. You rise above them all. In the name of Jesus.
Hello. Scriptures exhort us from the book of Proverbs. It says, my son, attend to my sayings. Incline thy ears to my words. Let them not depart from thy eyes and keep them in the midst of thee. As you have listened to this message, we believe that you are going to reap the blessings thereof if you attend to these words as well. That you will keep these words in the midst of your heart. That no matter the circumstance, your eyes are going to be fixed on these words. And as you have been blessed, we will tell you to share this message. Be an evangelist by sharing to others to be blessed. And then subscribe to this channel for us, because we have loads of videos. We have loads of content that is going to make you blessed. That is going to set you on course. That is going to set you ablaze. And don't forget to like for us. Thank you.